Please be ready for a dictation of part 2 from a write-up on fundamental rights taken from jagaranjosh.com. 5 seconds. Start. Article 21 states, no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to the procedure established by law. However, Article 21 puts a limit on the power of the state given under Article 246, read with the legislative lists. Thus, Article 21 does not recognize the right to life and personal liberty as an absolute right, but limits the scope of the right itself. Firstly, Article 22 guarantees the right of every person who is arrested to be informed of the cause of his arrest. Secondly, his right to consult and to be defended by a lawyer of his choice. Thirdly, every person arrested and detained in custody shall be produced before the nearest magistrate within a period of 24 hours and shall be kept in continued custody only with his authority. Article 23 prohibits traffic in human beings, women, children, beggars, or other forced labor militate against human dignity. Article 24 prohibits employing children below the age of 14 years in any hazardous profession. This right followed the human rights concepts and United Nations norms. Article 25 and 26 embody the principles of religious tolerance and serve to emphasize the secular nature of Indian democracy, that is, equal respect to all religions. Article 25 offers freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion, whereas Article 26 helps to manage religious affairs, which is subject to public order, morality and health, every religious denomination or any section. Article 27 provides freedom not to pay taxes for religious expenses on the promotion or maintenance of any particular religion. Article 28 prohibits religious instructions in educational institutions wholly maintained by the state. Article 29 provides protection of the interests of minorities. A minority community can effectively conserve its language, script, or culture by and through an educational institution. Article 30 states the rights of minorities, whether based on religion or language, to establish and administer educational institutions. The 44th Amendment has abolished the right to property as a fundamental right guaranteed by Article 19F and Article 31 of the Constitution. It is now only a legal right under Article 300A, gives protection against executive action but not against legislative action. Rights, in order to be meaningful, must be enforceable and backed by remedies in case of violation. This article guarantees the right to move the Supreme Court by appropriate proceedings for the enforcement of fundamental rights and deals with the Supreme Court's power to issue order or right or writs for the enforcement of fundamental rights. Article 33 empowers Parliament to modify the application of fundamental rights to the armed forces or forces charged with the maintenance of public order. On the other hand, Article 35 lays down that the power to make laws to give effect to certain specified fundamental rights shall vest only with the Parliament and not with state legislatures. Therefore, fundamental rights play a significant role because they are most essential for the attainment of the full intellectual, moral and spiritual status of an individual. Therefore, the objective behind the inclusion of fundamental rights in the Constitution was to establish a government of law to preserve individual liberty, building an equitable society and establish a welfare state. Stop.